is they will know, they will look at this and say, oh, it is validated. We can use this. This is good to go in production. Therefore, I can leave as a consultant, and everything you see here can be used for the stuff they need to build.
Wow.
So it's reference, it's documentation. Beside this, I am writing stuff down. But at the end of the day, would you rather read 20-page document that will tell you how stuff is sourced and connected to the rest of the system, or see a diagram of it?
Diagram, of course. You know, it's so beautiful, such a nice diagram.
Well, it's a pleasure to work. As soon as you figure out that from the design perspective, you get to understand the inside of the company. That for me, it's very rewarding, right? Because you can be in a position where you have someone pushing you from your back and say, hey, you need to do this and that. This is the brief, stay on the brief. I get to do something else. I get to do better. I get to talk to, I don't know, to VP of production. I get to talk to the head of operations or to the product owner for the whole division, saying, hey, how can we make this better? And then they explain what they do. And then I add to the context and I say, hey, have you heard of this technology? And it's not only a solution for the interface, but also a solution for the process. Around the warehouse, as soon as a piece of equipment is dropped off, a machine will have to come and pick it up. A machine in this case looks very similar to what you've seen at the airport. Those little trucks that are very flat that push the airplanes around the airport. They do the taxi. Yes, very flat, very weird things that push the airplane or bring the airplane from the runway. And those bits, they need to be managed. And that was a particularly interesting problem for me, because people driving those little trucks, Zalando calls them weasels, they are tow trucks. Those people have to be able to understand that not being able to fly above and see, hey, this is where that you are on the ground. And then you have to figure out where stuff is. And in a parking lot where you have 100 plus trucks and equipments, you don't have the time and the possibility to read all the number plates. You don't know where stuff is. Therefore, I had to design a client to update one of their existing clients that run on an iPad inside of those vehicles. And it was so interesting and so rewarding, because I had to design for a very special type of user that has no time to figure out, oh, I have a big screen and a no. He's driving and needs to pay attention to exactly that, to not damage the equipment, to not kill anyone on its way. And then there must be a order or a way to figure out, what am I doing right now? We are six people. We work on three shifts around the clock, around the warehouse, and we have to keep this going. So how do you design that? So I had to get myself into that position to figure out, how am I designing for someone that actually sees moving stuff at all times and needs to be able to also receive information? And that was a very particular problem to solve. And I was very happy at the end of it that I got a system that will allow everyone, based on a system of tasks, to pick up a piece of equipment for somewhere, to drop it in the right area, where they have an algorithm that calculates what would be the next optimal route based on your location. So you pick up something, you drop it at the dock, and then the next thing you do is going to be closer to you rather than to your colleague that is half a mile away. So in that respect, because I cannot get into details of that, I cannot show you that, unfortunately, it was really fun for me, because my job was, I was having my screen with the video, with the vehicle driving, and I had my iPad to my right, to my bottom right here, as a separate screen. And I was trying to say, okay, how does it look like when he's driving? I need to have at least one hand on the steering wheel, and then I have to have my feet engaged, and I have to look forward, and then I get the notification on the screen inside of the tow truck. How do I operate this? How do I operate this if I'm wearing gloves? How do I operate this if I have to make a maneuver? Or how do I ignore this? Can I get rid of that notification or whatever is distracting me as a driver? So before talking about how pretty the buttons are or the radius in the corner of the button or how big the fonts are, I had to think about how this system is going to be operated. And that was fun.
Yeah, the buttons and colors and arrangement is like, you know, alignment is the end game. The first game is like really, really understanding. And that's what you enjoy when